And we're on.
All right, Tiny Jeans. This episode of Your Mom's House podcast is brought to you by a new sponsor known as Mangrate. What is a Mangrate? Well, have you ever wanted to make restaurant style hamburgers or steaks, Tommy? Have you ever wanted that?
It's all I want every day, all day, every day.
You know when you go to a really nice restaurant and you get a nice cut of meat and it's cooked so perfectly?
Yeah.
How do they do that?
They take meats and then they put them over heat. They cook it.
But do you know something? A regular grill, like the grill most people just have?
Yeah.
You know how they cook with that?
Yeah.
It's just hot air.
That's hot air.
Smelly, stinky hot air. And that's why at home you can't get the same taste as they do in a restaurant.
Right.
But now with a Mangrate,
mm-hmm.
you buy the Mangrate and you put it on your already existing grill.
What?
That's right. And the way that the grill is designed creates smoke so that you get that nice smoky flavor.
It's like a grill.
Yeah.
That you put over
your existing grill. So you don't have to buy like a whole thing. You just buy the grate.
Oh, just the grate. Oh, I got you. That's delicious, huh?
Yeah, you big dummy. It's a Mangrate.
Okay. So, and they're offering...
I didn't mean to call you dummy. How are you supposed to know?
I didn't know.
You didn't. I'm sorry.
I'm excited about your teaching.
I'm really excited. No, because I looked at it and I thought, this is something like our people who listen to the podcast are going to be into.
Yeah. We have a lot of overweight listeners. And
we actually do.
We know this from the size of the shirts that you guys ordered.
I mean, it's so true. We just deduced this.
Initially never had 3X until you guys were like, hey, where are the 3Xs? And then we started ordering those.
Yeah. I'm tired of sewing two extra larges together.
And so now, and then this weekend somebody asked me for a 5X. And
no way.
Yeah. So look. I expect all of you to take advantage of this opportunity. And all you have to do is you go to yourmomshousepodcast.com. We have a banner sitting up there. You click on it.
Yeah.
And
let me click on it.
And you get 25% off. 25% off.
That's a ton off.
That's a lot.
Get the hell out of here. And do you know that if you take care of your man, great, okay,
yeah.
you buy him, you take care of him, you get your discount through yourmomshousepodcast.com, they can last a lifetime if you clean it properly. All you gotta do, use a little cooking oil, you gotta get the man great brush, you brush that sucker clean,
yeah.
you can use it your entire life. You can get fatter and fatter and fatter, as fat as you want.
Yes.
10X fat.
10X.
There you go.
Yes. I've been, you know, and I've wanted to do this.
I know.
I've wanted to put on 800 pounds before. This is a good way to get going. I love meat. I really do. Are you a meat eater?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely.
When we were in South Africa for the comedy festival last month, and South Africa is like the cattle. It's the only place that animals are okay to eat, I guess, in all of Africa. And they can't
run as fast.
Yeah, they don't have AIDS there. And but it's the beef capital. We had steak, I think, 15 out of 20 days.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
And I couldn't have been happier. Nothing makes me happier than eating beef. I absolutely love it. Like, chicken, I'm always like, I know it's better for me. It's healthier. I'm getting the protein I need. But if it was up to me, if there was no health ramifications.
Oh, well, if there was no health ramifications, of course, we'd eat steak.
But that's what I'm saying.
All day.
Beef, I would just have burgers.
Yeah.
And I love, you know, you get shitty burgers, and then sometimes you get accustomed to that shitty burger, and then you go either to like a real specialty burger joint, or you go to you buy good meat. It's always about
you make
good
your own.
And you make an awesome burger, and you're
on
like,
your Mangrate.
Nothing's fucking on a Mangrate.
And you know what, too? You can take it, it's portable.
You
just bring in the top. So you could do this for like.
You can take it to your friend's house.
Take it to your friend's house.
You or your mom's house.
Oh!
So you can take it to your mom's house.
What are those called when you go to the football game?
Tailgate. You can tailgate,
dude.
Listen, you guys, you want to go to the game, the football game, the baseball game, another game.
The basketball
the rugby game.
No hockey this season.
No hockey.
The high lie right. game.
The high lie game.
The golf
yes.
game.
The golf
tennis game.
Lawn
the
darts.
Lacrosse game.
Horseshoe
cricket.
Game, cricket,
the crying game,
football. If you're in Brazil.
Obrigado.
You get your Mangrate, you throw it out there, you get some meat, you get some ostrich meat, you get some what is it? Deer? What's it called?
Venison.
Yeah.
Venison. You shoot a deer in the morning. You go to the game.
You shoot a deer in the morning. You grab the deer. Your Mangrate. You
put
go
it in
to
the truck,
game.
Go to the game. You cook the deer. You gut the deer in front of people.
Everybody
at the game.
At the game. Hang it up. It's
awesome.
A real clean process.
Yeah. You kill an animal in the parking lot.
Oh, you trap the deer, take it to the game, snap its neck in front of a kid.
Oh, man.
Then hang it
there
up.
There you go.
Got it.
You know, there's coaches, there's football coaches I know that do these, every year they try to do these things, like, to motivate players. And, like, there was this one, I forget where the coach was. I think it was somewhere in the Midwest. Might have been, like, Oklahoma, Missouri, somewhere around there, where he, during spring ball, like, 10 years ago, he had a bull castrated in front of the team. And then they were like, it was like supposed to be like, that's what's up right there. Like,
why is that what's up?
I don't know. But then you think like, well, if you do that in front of, like, why, how is that going to
motivate?
What message does that send them? Does that send them like, you're this cow?
Yeah, you're right. This bull? You're going to cut my balls off?
Yeah, why are you going to do that to me? Like, it's just
fumble?
Are you going to punish me like that? And he was like, all right, take it in. Let's go 1, 2, 3 team or whatever. And you're like, all right.
Now, did you hear that story? Was that on ESPN? Or
it was like, I read it in, I think it was in Sports Illustrited. And it was like, you know when they have like those blurbs, like the weird shit of
exactly.
The week? They're like, look what this asshole
weird
did.
Motivation for the players. Like, huh.
Well, I know they've killed animals in front of players before too, you know?
Well, that's weird, man. What?
I don't know, man. Well, you know, like our friend David Cow was telling us, mm-hmm. a guy in South Africa.
His name is Cow?
Cow. K-A-U.
Oh, okay.
But he was saying that, you know, he's like comes from, he was born like what's it called? The
apartheid?
No.
Is that a town?
Townships.
Townships. There you go.
And so it's more like tribal, you know, stuff. And how in their culture, you sacrifice animals all the time for things like weddings, birthdays, funeral. So he was like, you know.
You could use a man crate.
David, if you're out there, you're listening, slit one of those sheep's throats you were talking about, those cows.
Man, grate it up.
Go to yourmomshousepodcast.com, click on the banner, 25% off.
That's crazy.
And we want to thank everybody, by the way, who's thus far ordered, bought your Amazon stuff through our banner.
How awesome is that one?
That's how you support the show. We really appreciate it. Thank you for buying. Do you use Amazon?
Yeah.
It's awesome, right?
What did you buy on Amazon? Tell us.
I bought my go-to gift for a little while was the Kindle.
Oh, wow. You're a good guy to know, man.
Yeah. Well, no, like, at first it was like, I watched my brother beat me out at Christmas. Like, he gave my mom a Kindle, and my brother's never given a good gift in his life. He's always like, here's a candle I bought an hour ago wrapped in a brown paper bag. Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
And this time he was like, he's got a job. He's doing better than me. So it's really enraging to see my mom go, oh, this is the beautiful gift. And me go, I got you a keychain.
Yeah.
A bottle opener. So when I saw that, I was like, okay. So then I got one for this girl I dated for a little while. Then I got one for a buddy of mine who travels a lot, and he was like complaining about how, no one has books anymore. Everyone's just walking around with stupid computers. And I'm like, uh-huh. And I got him a Kindle. I was like, now you travel with this instead of like
it's
five
amazing.
Different books and tell me it's not a better solution.
But isn't it
solution?
Like the easiest thing in the world? If you go to Amazon.com through your mom's house podcast.com, and you can even have a thing gift wrapped. You just put in that person's address, it gifts wrap it for like another more bucks, couple bucks.
Yeah.
And then that's it.
It's great.
They could go to Amazon.com on your website for your podcast, and they could click on it, and they could order my CD through Amazon.com.
That's a great
deal.
Now,
there you go.
Now, that is a party.
And they don't even know who it is yet. They don't know who it is yet. Just do it anyway.
We're never going to tell you. And we're never. It's a mystery guest.
We're never
going to expose. That would be the best
to introduce the guest. Ever. Ever.
Just a show where a third person is always talking. Who is that other
it's
person?
It's a mystery, yeah, the whole time. And he's really funny and fun to listen to. But we never tell the audience.
Never tell
That's
anyone.
That's part of the show. It's always
Are you okay,
guests.
Tommy? Is everything okay?
Yeah. No, I'm just looking at our levels. Are just high. That's all.
Yeah, is it my voice?
Do you want to pause for a moment and check it out? Like, is it weird?
No.
Is it me?
It's not you. It's just, they're just high. I listened back to the other thing. It was fine.
Does that mean this audience, this episode is going to be louder than most? Is that what?
Well,
that means?
I always balance it out with levelator afterwards.
Oh, okay.
So
is that a real thing?
That's a real thing.
Okay. Because
I picture you like putting a level on your computer and going, "Is level now?" And someone else going, "I don't think that's what that means."
The levelator.
No, it's just I don't know.
It's out of control.
It's not out of control. No, it's just hotter than usual. That's all. And
well, maybe because of our guest.
Oh.
Yeah. Probably a little more sexy than usual.
Somebody All right, came we'll in say... with their bright red beard.
John, what was
oh
that?
Oh, my God.
Mock the beard.
Did you see what happened?
Happening.
How God punished
what
me?
What was that?
I don't even know what the fuck fell.
That was God. He doesn't.
I don't even know what the fuck it was. Honest to God, it was more than your badge. And then, oh, that was so fucking... God punished me for bringing up Redbeard. That's why. Oh, my gosh. I don't even know where the object went.
My guess is it went under this chair somehow.
It's okay. Whatever it was.
Fuck it.
We don't need it.
Well, anyways, our guest tonight, do you want to introduce him, Tommy Buns?
John Candy from...
Oh, my favorite actor.
Too soon, dude.
It's Jon Huck, everybody.
Yay!
Comedian, wonderful guy, gentleman, bearded fellow, so we know we can trust him.
Is that a theory you have?
No.
Oh.
It's not.
I trust guys with beards.
You do? You married one.
It shows commitment. It shows I'm not afraid to smell what I had for lunch all day.
Mm-hmm.
What does your beard smell like right now? Let me. Can I touch your beard?
You can touch it, yeah. It's shampooed and conditioned regularly.
Ooh. Do you? You shampoo it a lot?
More than my your head hair. Yeah.
Wow. Do you smell your beard a lot?
Do you get smelly beard sometimes?
It's pretty rare. You know, if I've been laying in like...
Shit.
Well, just laying,
pile of shit.
Laying in like, you know, depression or whatever for a couple of days and you haven't showered and you've been eating like trail mix and you got like a raisin in here and you're like, So I'm sure it's probably not
You have a bigger beard than most. A lot of people don't have, you know, you have the thick, like a lot of people do this or even less than what I have.
I had
the real beard.
It's like half
I had
inch
what
long.
You had for a long time.
Yeah.
Oh. And then I went to, I did this, I worked on this awful, awful, awful TV show in Arizona. And when I was there, I was in like, it was like a really, just a really low point in my life. Like, probably the low, I was like miserable. Like,
yeah.
I drank vodka tonics in a bar until I pissed my pants and then kept drinking there until the pee dried and I could get out of there.
Wow.
Like, that's the kind of thing I was doing. And then going to work at like 7 in the morning.
Jesus.
It's a good week.
So one day, I wasn't shaving. I was barely showering. I was barely brushing my teeth. And I like walked by a van with tinted windows and I caught a glimpse of myself. I was like, Jesus, you look homeless. Like it had gotten so long and out of control. And when I came back to LA, the first commercial audition I went on with the beard like that, I got.
There you go.
So I was like, okay, I guess the beard plays. And then after that, when I said I was going to either take it off or trim it, my commercial agent was like, I don't want to tell you how to live your life, but
I'm going to.
You're going to do a lot less work if you shave.
Really? See, that's amazing. Beards add so much to a character.
But it's also the really color of it for commercials.
Yeah.
Especially for commercials. It's all about like how you look.
Yeah.
There's no acting skill involved, and unless you're a spokesman for something, there's no skill involved.
And I booked something when I was at my absolute fattest, and when it was for Domino's, was doing it in conjunction with ESPN, and then we had to plug all these different Domino's things, and they were like, "Hey, Domino's," they're like, "Oh, this is one of the reads for like the poppers," and one of the guys like, "What's a popper?" And the director's like, "I don't know." And then he goes, "Hey, Tom, what's a popper?" And I was like, "Yeah, I don't know." And they're like, "Come on, man." And I was like, "What?" And they're like, "You look like you've had a few poppers." And then I was like, oh, and it clicked for me. Like, oh, I got booked for this because I'm fucking fat. And why they booked me.
I had when I lost a weight over the last couple of years or whatever. And I went in for just an audition. They're taking my photo. And the girl keeps looking out from behind the camera. And she's like, Have you been losing weight? And I was like, yeah. And I was like kind of proud. Wow. I was like, yeah, yeah. And she's like, well, don't lose any more. And I was like, I have like another 20 to go. Why not? And she was like, because
we'll never use you again.
Yeah. It's like you're going out for fat guy roles. And I was like, oh, okay.
It's true, man.
Jesus.
So now I just don't do sit-ups. That's what I tell people. Now I always have a gut.
That's actually good for you. It's especially for a comedian. Like, why you looked perfect? I don't like to look perfect.
No, that's
people so
hate
crazy.
People hate really good looking comedians. Oh. Yeah. Men. Like, no, God, nobody wants to see a good, everything's perfect. I get laid all the time. Things are great. I look really good.
You
My parents
nothing,
are
you
married.
Can't be
all
a
right.
Comic.
Like,
you can't be a comic.
Then you should be doing something else in life. Like, you're already better than me. All right, stop.
Yeah, you can't be. Hey, real quick, because we got off our usual pacing.
Yeah, we didn't even do our intro. I'm all panicked about it.
Oh, it's coming. I got it. Don't okay. worry. Where can people see you next?
Mommies, I'm going to be in Peoria, Illinois, at the Jukebox Comedy Club next week, September 27th through 29th. Come see me. And then the following October 3rd through 6th, I will be in, Iowa, Des Moines, Iowa, on a tour with Dove Davidoff and Chewy of Chelsea Lately. So if you're a Chelsea Lately fan,
go
do that.
Big Chelsea Lately fans, go see her. I'm going to be in Toronto this coming weekend. I'm going to be the 21st, I think 22nd, 23rd, and I have random dates, shows around Toronto. I'm sorry to not having more details on it, but I just know that I'll have more tomorrow when this is up. So I'll be tweeting the more specific
and
stuff.
And it'll be on your website, right? Can they go to tomsegura.com?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But God, the worst thing, I found out I have to do shows with Brendan Walsh.
A dirtbag.
So he's the fucking worst.
Isn't he?
Absolutely the worst. And I have to do his shows with him. So it's like, if you want to see me, you'll have to sit through his shit probably.
Such a diva.
Sure, first. Because I'm sure they'll ask me to close if he's on the show. So
he's a bearded lad, too.
Yeah. He's just the fucking worst human being. So you can see me, and then, like I said, you'll have to sit through his shit. And after that, I'm going to be in Tacoma, the Tacoma Comedy Club.
Oh, I like Tacoma.
Washington there. And then I'm also going to Rumors.
Rumors.
I heard you were funny. And,
I love that club name. I think that's my favorite comedy club name of all time.
In Winnipeg, and I had a great time there. I'm going there for 2 full weeks.
Get the frock out.
Yeah.
Jeans, I'm going to miss you. I don't like it when you leave for 2 full weeks.
I did it last year. Remember I did it last year?
I know, I don't like that. I feel very
lonely.
This
gig, you move there. Like, you bring
take luggage. You bring your stuff.
Yeah. And you have days off. Like, you have days off. Like, you have Sunday, Monday off. So you're like, what do I do? Because you sit around the other days till fucking 8 or 9.
Thumbing your ass.
It's going to be a long one. So check me out, Toronto, Tacoma, Winnipeg. And yeah.
What about you, Jon Huck?
I'm going to be at the John Lovitz Comedy Club tomorrow.
Fuck yeah.
Tomorrow night, I think it's a 9 o'clock or 8 o'clock show. I really got that one down. And then...
just show up.
Yeah, coming up soon, I'm going to be headlining the Downtown Comedy Club when they reopen.
Great.
In LA, that's here in downtown Los Angeles.
Downtown
that's
LA,
a neat spot.
Man.
But anyone who hears this should go out to the Jukebox because it's, well, you're funny and it's a great club. I like that club a lot.
I love that club.
Yeah.
It's I've done it a couple times.
Dan is the first guy to let me headline anywhere.
And he's special. That's
and great. Then when I did it, we didn't even talk money. Like, it was like, I got all the way there and I'm standing at the bar and he's like, I just realized we never talked money. And I was like, look, man, I trust you. You brought me back here. You'll pay me what's fair.
Mm. Yeah.
And he did. It was great. I was really happy.
That's a rarity.
That's a fun club when it's 20 or sold out. Like, it's, you know what
I mean? Yeah, that's the thing is, and because he's so low key and not, he doesn't, there's no pressure, you know. There's some club owners like, well, I mean, what is this? This is 5 people.
He likes
comedy. What are we going to do?
That's why.
Yeah, he does. And he just wants people to have a good time. It's obviously money driven, but.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's what I like. That, you know what that means, mommies? When you hear comedians say that kind of stuff,
yeah,
it means it's a good club and it's going to be a greater time for you. So if you're in Peoria in the area, please come see me. I swear to God.
I guarantee you have nothing else to do if you're in Peoria than go to that club. So
they came. And they saw me when I was there. And I know they're going to come
and
see you. Yes.
Good.
People drove from Chicago. They came from
all over. Yeah, it's only 3 hours from Chicago. Yeah. And
so you definitely got to check out Christina.
Well, listen, and I also meet people. If you guys come, I stand out there and I meet you and I say hi to you and I talk to you.
Yeah, yeah, it's fun.
I love to meet people that listen to our podcast.
All right.
Well, I'm sure some of the local guys listen to you too. And those guys are usually really cool. Like for a local group of comics, like, they're all new, but they love comedy.
Yeah,
like, they love it. And they love hanging out and they're not obnoxious or a pain in the ass.
Are you guys ready to do this?
We got to start the show. We haven't even started the show, John.
We just did our pre-show.
We're not taping this?
No, we are.
No, we are. But we have an intro.
No, we wanted to get your voice warmed up. Are you ready to start? No, we haven't recorded anything.
Okay. Yeah, great. You're like, repeat everything you just said.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Here we go, man.
Let's go.
I want to fuck you up the ass.
You can stick it up your own, asshole.
I would if I could, bitch.
This shit is big time.
Who is Randy?
Don't bring anyone loving to this.
Your mom in the fucking stand!
Welcome to your mom's house. With Tom Segura. Tom Segura.
And Christina Pajitsky.
Welcome to your mom's house.
All right. Well, there it is.
Really nice audio you found, Tommy.
You like that?
I do. What's that from?
I just found it.
Was that Christmas at the Segura house last year?
I think so. Yeah. Something like that.
Hmm.
You like it?
Did you like that, John?
Yeah. Do you guys, is it different every time?
It's always different.
Oh,
yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah. He surprises me with something horrifying every time.
I try to.
You try to be as annoying as you can with it?
Well, if it makes me laugh, it then makes I pull it out and I'm just using it. Yeah.
You're like, and now Slayer haunting the chapel.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Turn it off.
It's absolutely my favorite. I mean, we have some good ones. Oh, here's an old one that we loved, okay?
Our next guest is originally from Danville, Illinois. He enjoys cold beer and hot music. Says that he and his mom don't see eye to eye on his love life. And he claims that his job has cost him several relationships. Please welcome Robert Faggot.
That's not real.
It's real.
Faggot is rather an odd name.
Yeah, you know, it is an odd name.
Yeah, that's a real one.
What?
Yeah.
That should be every time. Yeah. I would never get tired of hearing that.
I spend a lot of time looking for these.
First of all, I love everything that was wrong with the guy to begin with. His job has cost him relationships. He's a raging alcoholic. It's like Robert Faggot.
Yeah. You think it's the cause and effect? You think your last name might be the root of some of the problems
you're
having?
Oh, God. That is insanity.
It's really...
Yeah.
It's really crazy.
Do you know that there's people with the last name Hitler and Stalin? Like, if you Google it, like, I looked in the white pages a few years ago, and there's still people named Adolf Hitler and Stalin.
Not Adolf Hitler?
Yeah, I swear to God, Google
it. What are you looking at, the Idaho phone book?
Yeah. Actually, yeah, it is.
Of course there's people named Adolf in the Klan and stuff. Yeah. Like,
wait, where are you from?
I'm from Illinois, southwest suburbs of Chicago.
Okay, so yeah, and you are a Cubs fan, right?
Yeah, I see. Unfortunately, that.
Yeah. You've always rocked that hat.
Not the exact one.
You've always had that exact hat.
Oh, God. Dude, I've peed in Cubs hats. Like, I've gone through two this year. I went to a fish show at Alpine Valley after the jukebox weekend, and I got drunk and took acid and fell down on the lawn, and like my hat fell off and some hippie took it, and I was like, all right, well, we're done with that hat anyway.
I love that you're consistent with it. It's always a Cubs hat.
Yeah, no, I wear other hats,
you do?
Too. I do. I'll wear, like, I have three different Cubs hats that I wear. And then I have, I like minor league baseball.
Do you?
Yeah, so I'll wear, like, a Toledo Mud Hens hat or something.
It's incredible how much comedy has come out of, like, the greater Chicago area.
Yeah,
yeah,
right?
There's been a lot. Yeah. I didn't start doing comedy until I moved to L.A.
Right.
So when people found, like, people are like, oh, hey, you're kind of funny. Where are you from? I'm like, oh, I'm from Illinois. Like, oh, did you start in Chicago? Like, no. They're like, why not?
Yeah.
And they'd get mad. You moved here? I'm like, I didn't know. Not smoke meth anymore. That's why I moved here.
I know the people always, I started in LA too, and I always get the, why'd you come here to start? I'm like, I didn't know.
Yeah.
I was young. What do you mean to do, man?
When did you move out here?
I moved out here in 2002, January 1st. So...
You did, yeah. You wanted to start it off right, right?
Yeah, I mean, I just, I moved. I was only out of college. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 months. 6, 7 months.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say years.
No,
you're younger than me, probably.
Yeah, I was 22 when I moved out. So
that's crazy. And I met you when you were 23. Mm-hmm. We started doing. We were friends and open micers and stuff.
Yeah.
You just moved here when I met you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah.
And these are the days, people. These are the days.
I know, man.
It was pretty wild, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's been a while.
I started in L.A., but I grew up here.
It's a little different.
It's different. Yeah. But I didn't want to do stand-up. I didn't want to do open mics in Hollywood where people could see me. So I would drive an hour and a half out to, like, Huntington Beach.
Yeah.
And do Martini Blues. Do you remember that club?
I never did it, but I've heard many, many things.
Yeah. It got shut down because roaches took it over.
Ugh.
And they couldn't kill them. So...
That's not good.
They're endangered, so you can't just kill roaches.
Mm. What brought you? Do you know you were coming for entertainment?
No, you just
picked L.A.
I had a friend from college who was graduating. I graduated college in '98,
mm-hmm.
and then my friend was graduating the next year.
Yeah,
and I did nothing in between that year. I went to Europe. I lived in my car. Then I started living on the floor of some guy's apartment.
You're a real comic, man. That's why.
But I wasn't doing any.
But it's already in you.
Yeah, maybe. But it was like, and then I was just doing a bunch of shit I shouldn't have been doing. Like,
yeah.
You know, you get boredom in the suburbs leads to drugs. That's simply how it works in my experience.
Yeah.
And so I was like, I got to get out of here. My friend was like, I might move to L.A. because his uncle, he had like a hip uncle who directed, a couple of really good documentaries, music documentaries, one called Hype about the Seattle music scene and one called Scratch. But he's out here making documentaries, and my friend was like, yeah, I went to visit him. I worked in the art department on some thing. It's like basically you're a mover. You just move furniture. I'm like, I can move furniture. I'm like, I'll go with you, man. Maybe we'll do that. Like, I don't fuck. I had no clue. I had no plan. I got out here. He found a way in to production, and I didn't. So I was working as a temp, like walking because my car was a dump. So I walked from my apartment in Echo Park to downtown.
Yeah.
Temped, walked home, ate Jack in the Box three times a day, and drank a 12-pack every day.
Oh, my God.
At one point, I weighed 265 pounds.
What do you weigh now?
I weigh 222, 223.
Wow. You with another 40-some pounds.
Yeah, jeez. Dude. It was no wrists. Like, no, just like, and like my beard was like, almost like maybe it was a goatee even. Yeah. Like, just something gross. Like, everything about me was disgusting back then. Yeah.
I love about you the way you shit on yourself.
That's
the best. It really is. It's so endearing. And real. It's genuine.
It is. And I love, like, someone was like, hey, I'm having a roast. You should come out and roast me. I'm like, I can't. I'm lucky I didn't wake up on my kitchen floor. I can't make fun of anybody else. Like, I have no business going, you're stupid. And because it's just.
But do you want more water?
Sure.
He's right put there. His mouth on okay. that.
Oh, but no, but I'll pour it into there.
Does it bother you?
It does. It makes me sick to my stomach.
That actually, I don't know if I had any of that one. I think that's yours.
Oh, I put my mouth on.
You're like, this
has
just been sitting here so long, it's evaporated down to this.
Yeah, it's been there 7 months.
It's been there a while.
So you're an Illinois guy, so I thought maybe, I don't know if it's appropriate or not. But, oh, shit. Well, you gotta do it now.
This is Mike Singletary,
and so we're going to play you audio clips, and you tell us which is Mike Singletary.
Oh, cool. All right.
Hey, baby, we're going to be here all day. We're going to be here all day, baby. I like this kind of party.
That's clip one.
I want to say this. Number one is I apologize for the start.
Wow.
That's all you get.
Oh, so I got to pick which one is the real.
Yeah. Which is the real. This is a guy from the suburbs of Chicago, everybody. So you know, he knows who Mike Singletary is.
Samurai Mike, I stop him cold. I'm part of the defense.
Are you a big Bears fan?
Oh, yeah, dude.
Oh, shit.
Give you the Super Bowl shuffle.
I mean, this is for pride right here.
I know. That's what's pissing me off because I really want to say it's the first one. But then,
do you want to hear it again, maybe?
Do you want to roll it back?
Can I hear the second one again?
Sure, okay. sure. Just
I'm not sure I've decided either.
All day, baby! I like this kind of party!
I want to say this. Number one is I apologize for the start.
Oh, man.
This is close,
well,
huh?
Walk us through your process. Tell us what you're thinking.
It's all right.
I feel like the first one might be somebody newer to football. I feel like it doesn't. I mean, I feel like
Why
the second one
that?
Is. I feel like the second one sounds like Mike Singletary's voice, but he's struggling through whatever he's trying to say.
Right.
Which I feel like I might have seen in a press conference not that long ago.
Okay.
Meaning when he was the Niners coach.
Okay.
Because he talked a lot of nonsense and he would get in front of the camera all the time. And
yeah.
It was a little bit disappointing. But that first one, that's the kind of shit he might say.
Right.
Like, we're going to be here all day, baby. I like this kind of party.
But I like how you say that. Say that again.
Could you maybe do your version of that?
Yeah.
My version of what?
Just
what
say, you just say heard? Like he says
like
it.
Like he said it?
Oh, like he said it?
Or what you heard?
Or do you want me to say it like I would say it?
Say both. How would you say it?
I would say like this. Hey, we're going to be here all day. I really like this kind of party.
Okay.
Thanks for coming out, everybody.
And how would what you heard, how would that?
We going to be here all day.
Yeah.
I like this kind of party.
There you go. Yeah.
Interesting. See, he did a black guy's voice, but it was a white guy doing a black guy's voice.
It was, yeah.
Not like you. Could you do it as a black guy's voice?
I love this kind of product.
See?
That's pretty.
Now, when you hear that, do you think, oh my God, is there a black guy in the room?
We gonna be here all day.
Wow.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah. I mean, I can see you guys, so you I don't like look around and go, is there a black guy in the
eyes.
Room? Like, yeah.
Close your eyes, John.
It's not a very.
Let Tom do it. Go.
We gonna ride today.
What do you think of that?
Oh wow! Is there a black guy in here?
There
see,
you go.
Is this how, you can't even.
Is it? Did he? Is he? He yeah. ran out, far yeah. up my eyes.
It happens. I can't. It's just a gift. The gift comes to me.
Man, part of me really wants to pick two, but the part of me thinks it's one.
I love this. This is how you're supposed to play the game. You're putting thought. You're not discarding, oh, this is whatever. You're really thinking about it, as you should.
Yeah, because it's embarrassing, because it's the kind of thing, like, when I was in college, I used to tell people I could tell the difference between Bush and Bush Light.
Really?
Wow.
Of course I could not. No one can. It's like piss and other piss and whatever. It doesn't matter. But if you're listening, if you work for Bush or Bush Light and you're listening, I don't really think it's piss. Send me some. But like, so I put on a blindfold and they literally poured shot glasses of it. And I guessed right every time.
You did?
I guessed right every time. But they were like, oh, well, I guess he can tell. Like after 10 times, really, I was just like, man, man. And I was literally randomly picking the shot glasses and putting no thought into it. Now I'm doing this and I'm going to mess it up. And
that's okay.
You know what, though? Don't put so much pressure on yourself. It's okay. Not everybody gets this right all the time.
I'm going to go with one.
One. Okay. You heard it, folks. He is going with number one. Just real quick to get it back. We'll.
Which is Mike Singletary?
Mike's number one.
Hey, baby, we're gonna be here all day. We're gonna be here all day, baby. I like this kind of party.
I want to say this. Number one is
That's either Mike.
Apologize for the start.
No, you picked.
You got to stick to it.
That's either him or somebody who's got like a learning disability or something.
Well, do you want to know the answer?
Yeah.
They're both Mike Singles.
You're kidding.
Are you serious?
Oh, my God.
Are you serious? Yes. Oh, my God. Oh, man.
You tricked us both.
That was good because that first one, though, it sounds like a guy, like, that sounds like something from last week's games. Like, come on, I lied. That's kind of fun. You know what I mean? So it's like,
come on.
He does, like, the hillbilly version.
I love it.
Come over here. Is this kind of party?
But that other one sounds like he's apologizing for what a crappy coach he was in San Francisco.
Dude,
like,
you nailed both analysis correctly. you got both right. That was a clip from him at a press conference as a coach at 49ers.
Yeah, and he was like
I'm
sorry that I'm not good at this.
I apologize for this. And then, I love this kind of product.
That's when he was on the field as a bear, fucking at Soldier Field, just wrecking somebody.
Yeah, he was.
And it's from NFL Films. It's like it actually, if you watch, by the way, Steve Sable died. Did you see that? He died today or yesterday?
I did see that.
Wow. Steve Sable's the president of NFL Films, so you've seen him every time.
I was walking out of work with my boss, and they have monitors in the thing, and he was like, oh, Steve Sable, and they were talking about, I didn't know he was 70.
Yeah, so he was the guy that would always come out and be like, he would introduce the film, like, you ever wonder why, you know, players, what they do on their day off, and then they play, like, the film, or you ever wonder what it's like to be in the locker room? And
NFL Films is...
It's great, man.
It's awesome.
It's great.
They can show you clips from, like, you watch clips from a game last week, and it looks like this must have been 89.
Oh, yeah.
Or, you know what I mean? It feels so vintage. You're like...
Shooting it on film absolutely changes the game completely. But when NFL Films, you know how they have... Like, when a movie starts, it has its own, like, opening. Like,
I'm
going to
get more
MGM.
Wine when you guys talk about football.
Okay.
Yeah.
This has, like, an MGM opening, The Lion Roars or whatever.
Yeah.
So when NFL Films plays their, I don't know if they still do it, but for years and years and years, when they did their open of, like, this is NFL Films.
Right.
It includes Mike Singletary going, I love this kind of butter.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
So it's like a, you know, a regular thing. So, anyways.
And you know what? Here's another thing I think. I think Ryan Sickler had that as his incoming message.
Holy shit.
And he played it for me at the improv one night. He was like, hey. And I was like, who is this? He's like, it's Mike Singletary. I was like, oh, okay.
You are very, very observant. I might have already.
That might have leaked in because I don't know that I would have guessed right. Had I not already heard that, maybe.
Well, Ryan did have that as his voicemail, and it was Mike Singletary.
Yeah, okay.
Yes. So you put another thing. That, look at you, very.
Now ask me what I did 2 days ago, and I'll be like, and I'll start crying and shit my pants.
Very good. Man, he really knew his stuff.
But you did. I didn't. I would have never thought that you would have tricked me. I would have never thought you'd be like, oh, I got a good idea.
I tricked you.
Yeah, because what if I was like, It's a trick. Neither of them are Mike Singletary, and I would have slammed your laptops to the ground.
That would have been scary. And I've been like, please don't break my stuff. Please stop breaking my stuff.
That's a good game.
How was, I did forget to ask, you know, for the show. I mean, people want to know. I had a fucking amazing, I had three shows in Brea. I did Thursday and Friday only.
Mm-hmm.
And I absolutely had the best shows.
Really, James?
I love
fucking
Brea.
Great time. I so wish I could just hit that up for a weekend every 6 months or something.
Yeah, whenever you felt like it.
Yeah, yes. Or just like tell them, I want to come just Friday, Saturday. Make that happen. The best crowds. So good.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I got my live. Mommies?
A lot. A lot. I want to thank them. If you, to our listeners that came out to those shows, thank you so much because I really had the best time. Absolutely. So much fun. And I actually, I went there the day my new CD just arrived.
Oh.
And it's not even on sale yet, but the hard copies arrived at the house. So I brought them with me and you guys were buying them up. So thank you for that too.
Oh, that's nice, Gene.
Yeah, that was cool.
You guys find, and this will sound stupid because you're thanking people.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
I love that song.
Do you guys, more people come out to see you because of what you do on here?
Yeah.
Happens a lot. Yeah.
You know what's weird? There's a split. Like, a lot of people like Chelsea lately, so they'll come out just for that. But then now the mommies come out more, and it's so awesome.
It's great. It's really crazy is what percentage. First, you take the percentage of people that bought tickets, and then you take, for me, then what percentage is from podcasts in general. And it's a huge percentage.
Really?
Yeah. Like, some people will be like, I saw you on Comedy Central, and when I saw you were coming, that's when I came. But that's the minority.
I was going to say, that's got to be rare, because I feel like...
That doesn't sell tickets.
Yeah. No, it does.
Do you know what it takes, though?
But I'm saying, compared to the podcast listeners...
Right, because it's consistent. Like, every week you're in people's ears and their living rooms.
Yeah.
And they get to know you. It's way
more
personal.
I mean, I would say, like, let's say one show, I sold 60 tickets, right? Like Thursday. I would say of those people, five to 10 were something from that wasn't a podcast. I saw you on something. I'm a fan of whatever. I got your first album. I heard you on Pandora.
I saw your fat ass Domino's commercial back in the day.
Fucking Domino's commercial. Shit like that. The other 50 are podcasts, but the funny thing is that it's all different podcasts.
Right, like, all the ones you do, like a Death Squad.
Yeah.
They'll
be like, so I heard you on Rogan, Your Mom's House, I heard you on the Sklar Brothers like a year ago. That kind of shit is the one that I'm like, really? And they're like, yeah, I heard that episode, and then I saw your name, and then I decided to come, and I'm like,
wow.
That one appearance, and they're like, yep. Yeah, people really latch onto a podcast if they like.
But I think I agree with you. It's like another way to say, it's another way to feel like they know you. You know what I mean? They're here every week. Like, and it's great, and it's almost terrifying in the sense that, like, because of Facebook and Twitter and this kind of stuff, you guys were just so much more accessible.
Yeah.
Than, like, if you go back to the 80s, like, people in, Wisconsin couldn't be like, hey, what's Sam Kinison doing tonight? Like, they can't just, like, go listen to something that he might be yelling about. It's like...
Dude, and now even, like, when I was in West Palm, I have no problem with this, but the manager would come in and take photos of us in the green room and then put them up on Instagram. So now it's even like, what are you doing when you're not on stage? Yeah. What are you doing for breakfast?
Yeah,
what are you doing?
Yeah.
Like I said, I don't give a shit. Like, it's fine, but it's just another level of intimacy now that your audience really knows everything about you.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
It's really...
And you know what's really scary?
Crazy.
Can you imagine now that you've been at it for... the couple of years of podcasting.
Yeah.
Can you imagine all your shows without those podcast fans there?
Yeah, I know.
Like, how sad and depressing that would be.
How sucks. Quickly you would have already given up on comedy and moved
on. Oh, man, because they're the thing. That's the thing that, like, sometimes I'll do a city where no one knows me from anything. And then you find out that, like, oh, no, there's a table of 10 that are podcast fans. That'll give me, like, such a boost internally where I'm like,
these people know. They came out for a reason. Yes. It's not like, oh, it's giving free tickets or I randomly walked in here because it had air conditioning.
Or somebody, or like somebody was walking through the mall and they were like, we want to go see comedy, but we want to see it on our terms. I don't know who this is,
but it better be the humor that I have, and it better be the jokes that I want to hear.
Yeah. And you're like,
because I've seen a comic once and he's not like you.
Yeah.
He was funny.
He was funny.
So well, that shit.
And I gotta say, even like when I was on Chelsea Lately pretty regularly, like maybe every 2 weeks, that didn't do shit for me the way this podcast does.
Isn't that
like,
crazy?
People will kind of recognize your face or your lipstick or remember your hair from Chelsea Lately. But now they're like, oh, you're a mom. And they know everything about you. Yep. And they're on board. I can tell now when I look out in the audience who's a podcast listener by how they behave. Even by how they listen to me, they're not talking. They're not the assholes yep. being disruptive.
Right.
They're listening and they're laughing and they're like a heightened level of attentiveness. It's yeah. really kind of bizarre and cool. Like now I can be like, oh, I know that's a mommy.
I know.
So weird.
Like I've had where my opener is fucking with somebody in the audience. And then I get up there, I'm like, who are they fucking with? And then I'm like, what's going on? And then I realize, oh, the comic was being a dick. Like, it's a podcast fan. And they're like, were smart ass back to him. And I was like, I'm like, good for you. That guy was a fucking yeah. asshole for trying to pick on you for no reason. Like, I can put it together now. Like, I see him like, oh, no.
Yeah.
You know, and then the comic will be like, did you see me talk to that guy? And I'm like, yeah, he kind of.
Did you see me making fun of you talking to that guy when I got up there?
Yeah, it was kind of stupid of you to do that.
Do you have a podcast?
I do now. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
But great.
We haven't put anything out yet.
Great, promote it.
Yeah,
yeah. It's going to be called Full Count.
All right.
It's me and Sean Halpin.
He's great.
And we're calling it Full Count because it's a baseball term that means three balls, two strikes.
Yes.
It's a nerve wracking. It's a full count, but I only have one ball. He has two. And we both have two.
Oh, that's right.
And we both have two dicks, so it's like,
yeah. Now, do you feel like it was insensitive of me to talk about that castration thing?
No, yeah, because that's what happened. My high school football coach brought me in front of everybody, cut one of my balls off, and said, "All right, bring it in."
Now, you told me this story in a car ride one time.
And yeah, when you left the phone on, when you called her, and you were talking, and then you. She was out of town. You called her. You left the phone on. And you talked about beating off. And then she was like, "Ah, nice. I heard you talking about beating off."
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you were talking about jerking off to somebody.
I don't even. How do I remember this shit? Like, that was like 3 years ago or 4 years ago.
She's used to it.
Yeah,
I know. No, I know. But how do I remember
this? I know. Like, you have this thing where you can remember shit.
That's great.
But it's not. But then I run into people who are like, I saw him 2 days. Like, I literally saw this guy at three different comedy clubs in 2 days. Could not remember who he was. I'm like, I don't
really
know. I don't know. Do I know you? He keeps talking. Oh, and then last time, like, oh, you were there last night? Yeah.
Well, I forget people's faces constantly and names. Wait, so how did you lose your ball?
Cancer.
Oh, cool.
Yeah,
good.
It was pretty cool.
Oh, nice, Christina. No.
I don't still have it or anything, and don't worry, you guys can't get it from me.
But that's
unless you put my other ball in your mouth, then you might.
I never knew that about you until I went to your website today and I looked at your about. Because I was like, oh, what the fuck? I didn't even know that about you
yeah,
at all.
Yeah, I mean, I have like 10 minutes of or 15 minutes that I can do on it when I
do it now.
Go for it.
And then at the end, you're like, that's not funny.
It's, I mean, you know, just tweak it a little bit. You need to tighten it up. That's all.
Just keep at it. Smile when you
keep
deliver those jokes.
It.
Be yourself.
You're a likable guy.
So
crazy.
When did this happen to you?
I was 19, so.
Oh, wow.
Before the dawn of Jesus. It was a long time ago. Yeah,
it's a terrifying thing. I can only.
Oh yeah, I mean you're 19. You think you're gonna? My mom was like, the doctor was like, everything's gonna be fine. We're gonna have to take it, but it's you know. And then when they told me like I had to do the chemo, that's when I freaked out. Like I was like, everything else was cool. I was like, yeah, you can take the right.
How
that's
was it
fine.
Discovered? How did you find?
I was in college and I sat down to take a shit on the toilet. Obviously.
Yeah.
Actually, not obviously. If anyone's ever met me, I could have shit anywhere back
Pizza
then.
Box,
whatever. Mm-hmm. And I sat down and I was like and like it wasn't. I couldn't. My right testicle was swollen. Like
notable. It was
yeah,
notable.
I was definitely like I was like oh okay, and then of course you know you go tell your like college friends who are all just sitting around. Smoking bongs and you're like, oh, my right testicle is like huge. And there's just a pause and then everyone just starts laughing like, oh my God, you have big balls! Ah! And then like took 3 days for one girl, my friend Elise goes, hey, because we're laughing about it again, you know, and she was like, you might
want to... Are you showing it to people?
No, I wasn't showing it to people.
But you just said
we were mocking it and we were laughing about
it. And she said...
She goes, you might want to get it checked out because a friend of mine in Nevada had that and it was turned out to be cancer. Another fucking hush comes over the room and then we all just start laughing again. I'm like, yeah, cancer!
But you're 19.
Yeah, and I was like smoking cigs and doing drugs, being a pig, like...
You know, it happened to a kid I knew in college too. He was probably 20. I can't remember his last. First name was Kelly. Dude named Kelly, and he got it. And, you know, he had his had it removed. But
it's the most common form of cancer.
Yeah, I mean, I just remember just being like just so scared for him. You know.
Well, that's the thing. Like when I called,
terrifying when you're 20 and 19.
Yeah. When I called my friends, like, you know, my friends, like I've known. Like since grade school, we've been like really like friends, you know? And
yeah.
So I call these guys and I'm like, hey, don't make fun of me. But I have cancer and they got to take my right testicle. And all of them, every single one of them was like, why would I make fun of that? Like,
yeah. No.
What are you talking about, yeah. Dude? Like,
psycho.
Like, because I, you know, and in my head, everything's just like,
don't
oh,
make
man, they're
fun
gonna,
of me.
Yeah, that was literally, I was like, this is kind of rough on me. So don't like mock me about it. And they were like, no one's going to mock you for having cancer, you yeah. weirdo. And I was so like, oh, okay.
But you're healthy and cancer-free.
Yeah.
Do you get it checked regularly?
I do. I was trying to think of it. By this guy who lives down the street from me.
Yeah.
No, I go to a doctor like once a year, and I always... Everything that's ever wrong with me, though, I think I have cancer. So sure. Like, I went to the doctor, and she's like, what's wrong? I'm like, well, I have throat cancer. And she's like... uh-huh, why? I'm like, because I'm sweating and my throat and I have throat cancer. And she's like, she's like, you have a fever. I go, yep, throat cancer. And she's like, cancer does not have a fever. You don't have a fever. I'm like,
fever.
You sound like my mother. If I go like, I scratched here today. She's like, you have cancer. Immediately. I'm like, this hurt. Or this hurt. She's like, you probably have cancer.
That's really helpful. Do that. But doesn't everybody, like the minute you're like, I've got cancer.
Yeah.
Like I had some problems like peeing a while ago and I was like, I have bladder cancer, I'm dying of cancer.
I gotta get life insurance on you.
Don't, because I have good stock. I'm Hungarian, I'm Eastern European, we're cockroaches.
Yeah, you're gonna,
we live forever.
You're gonna barrel through it.
I never get sick.
Barrel through. I love that term.
You're gonna barrel through life, man, you know.
I do. And I'm speaking of
holy shit.
You know what that music means, right, John?
Are we going to guess the real Jim McMahon?
You know what time it is? It's time for a dental update. What's going on with your teeth?
Oh, my teeth are great, actually.
You have a really nice smile.
Yeah, let me look at those chompers.
Look at the bottom row, too.
Ooh, perfect. Did you have braces?
I had braces when I was in eighth grade.
Wow.
And I just got this new dentist who is awesome.
Really?
Dr. Stephanie Phelps, DDS.
Jesus, lady.
Free plug right there.
Dude, because she is, you get to lay in the chair and watch SportsCenter on a TV with a remote that you control.
Stephanie Phelps,
what?
DDS, here I come.
She's pretty.
Nice.
I mean, she's married with kids. I don't want to, like, I'm not being horny
like
on
Stephanie
or anything.
Likes,
but, I mean, it doesn't hurt when, like, a pretty person is touching your mouth and not
it's
some
a horrible
hairy
situation.
Dude with a bad mustache and, like, bushy eyebrows. And she's done work for little to no money. Like, I found her, like, my last girlfriend was like, hey, show my friend your teeth. You got a problem with, I had a toothache. And I was like, that hurts. And she's like, show my friend. I go, I'm not showing people my teeth. And she's like, she's a dentist, weirdo.
Oh.
So I show her. She goes, just come into my office. The dentist I had wanted like $6,000 or $600 to fill this thing and do whatever. She's like, I'll do it for $30.
What?
I was like,
what?
Done and done.
Where
and
is she?
Don't give her a specific, but what part of town is she in?
Beverly Hills.
Oh, that's where you want to go. That's where you want
to
go.
You know why? You do want to go there.
Yeah.
And not to sound like an ass, but I went to, when I lived in Hollywood, I hadn't been to a dentist in forever. You know how it is.
Nobody has.
Yeah, it was
that's
like,
why we do this segment, because it's horrifying usually.
What was your initial visit like when you hadn't been in forever? How bad was it?
It was awful because I went to the just
that's
cheap,
what we want to hear.
This
that's
cheap, cheap place in Hollywood. And it was like this rush. Like I walked in there and it was like a dirty waiting room. So I'm like, I already do not like this. Like I hadn't been to a dentist since I was a kid, but it was in the suburbs. Everything was clean. Ooh. Everyone's like, and I got nitrous for everything. Like, oh, you're getting a tooth cleaning. I'm like, you better put that thing on me. And this place was filthy. The lady behind the counter was disgusting. And everybody in there was gross. And then when I got in the chair, it was almost like he'd put the chair in like a tiny hallway. So we weren't even like an actual room. And then I looked like I'd come off the set of a fucking porno movie when I left. He'd gotten all the paste that he was cleaning my teeth with. He got it all in my hair and all on my beard and all on my shirt.
Like, that white
I looked
stuff?
Like I'd been in a fucking, like everyone's just jerking on me. And that was it. And I left and I would just not... I didn't feel good. I didn't feel clean.
And you paid for this.
Yeah, and exactly. Like, I can... Yeah, it was
now,
not good.
John, do you have bondings or...
I don't.
Fake teeth anywhere?
I don't. I have one they filed something down and put a crowned it or
you
something.
You got really nice crown. Teeth, man.
Yeah, those are yours.
Thanks. You, I have a lot of cavities.
How many cavities do you have?
They're filled. I have 13.
Wow, that's a good number.
Good.
But they're filled, and now I floss. And the last time I was at my dentist,
hey,
that's what we talk about.
Wait a
about.
Minute. Ding, yeah. ding, ding.
Because I don't want a pretty lady to look at my mouth and go, what are you, a fucking pig?
Isn't like, that yeah. funny that, like,
so
that's
important.
The power, though, but that's the influence of women on men.
Uh-huh.
That even, like, she's married with kids, nothing's ever going to happen. You don't want to be embarrassed by the pretty lady as yeah. a man. That can influence you to behave.
It should.
But because
I'm saying, yeah, but like something
it's
that's not even, it's not even.
It's not a sexual
like,
thing.
He's not going to date her.
No, yeah, not, I have no desire. No,
it's still,
not at all.
It's just you don't want the pretty lady to look at you and be like,
what a pig.
Yeah, even though she wouldn't. She's a professional.
Yeah, she's, like, yeah, but she goes, she'll tell, like, she doesn't tell you about her patients, but she's like, because I'm, she's like, you. This is really. She's like, get a nice set of teeth. I'm like, well, you know, I just started flossing a lot. I floss in the shower, and she goes, that's what I would tell everybody. It's just weird if I start talking about people in the shower. You know what I mean? But yeah you should floss in the shower. I brush my teeth in the shower too. I'm like, yeah. She's like, yeah.
No, why does she recommend in the shower?
Because you're already in there.
Yeah.
And like the reason, the reason people don't floss is because it's something on top of everything else that you're already doing in the bathroom.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Nobody wants to be in there for that long. It's like, all right, yeah. Like, yeah. Ah, flossing. But if you do it in the shower, one, it doesn't splatter shit all over your mirror.
That's right.
And two, it's the same. I brush
you
my teeth. Like, if I could
out.
Read books in there, I would.
Sure. Can I
like
tell you,
Kramer.
Did you notice there's dental floss in our shower,
yeah,
by the
yeah,
way?
Yeah, I do it in the shower now, too.
Same reason.
I do it in the shower, too.
Yeah. That's you know, it's funny, John.
You guys
John?
Just start flossing?
We got on a big kick of it. I mean, she's always flossed.
Not always. But I'm not going to say. But a lot, 3 years ago, yeah. I started
I got on a kick
flossing.
After I had one cavity for the first 31 or 32 years of life, 31 years. And then I went, hadn't been in a couple of years, and that's when we started really doing dental updates. I went and I had 6 cavities.
Yeah.
And I was like, fuck. And he was like, he's like, they're all clearly cavities from not flossing. Like the way.
Yeah, the where they are. They're
yeah,
on the inside.
Where they are.
In between.
He's like,
yeah.
He's like, you're an asshole. You should fucking floss.
And I was, but that's their. You know that's what they're thinking too. Like,
of course.
Hey, dickhead, it takes you fucking 1.5 minutes to floss, okay? It takes you longer to put your shoes on and tie them.
I was a flosser if I had corn or pulled pork.
If I,
and
yeah.
That was about
yeah.
It.
Right. Maybe
and
if an apple skin got up there, you know?
Like, I can't. All right.
But now it's like you can't go without it. I was on.
Oh, no,
the,
I freak out.
I was on the airplane yesterday eating turkey jerky, and it got wedged, and I was fucking going ballistic. I took a string out of my sock, and just started flossing with that string.
Yeah, I do business cards.
Oh yeah,
I'll take a business if I can't get it.
Yeah,
just to. And now the other thing that sucks is when you have a couple of your molars are filled, you get stuff stuck in them more.
Yep.
So
yep,
now
yep,
I
yep.
actually, I it's now it's compulsive. I feel I'm like shit. I gotta go floss. You know,
I've never talked about this much dental stuff.
Okay. Oh, I didn't tell you this.
Other people, yeah.
A guy this weekend came to our show in Brea. Didn't catch his name. He was like, "I absolutely love the show." He's like, "You guys changed my life," and I was like, "Come on!" And he goes,
"I had."
He shows
cancer.
Me his teeth. He goes, "I floss." He goes, "I just got braces because of the show." And I floss now
wow,
every day.
Wow, cool.
Like, how did you forget to mention that at the top of the segment? This
know.
Is a segment that helps people be better people.
This is the segment that changes your mouth.
You guys are now the reason that that guy will probably not die alone.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Because
he
no
looked good.
Girl wants a
hey,
dude
kid,
with
he
a shit
he had a girl
mouth.
With him, so he's already okay. He's doing all right.
You know what? I don't
Bravo.
Remember. I don't remember if you can floss while you have braces, because I had braces. I don't
they
think I
tell
flossed.
You to, but the process is so ridiculous that you just don't.
I think maybe now
it's like go
they're
up
a little different,
in.
Right?
Well, I had the wires.
You did?
Yeah.
Wires? What do you mean? Like retainers?
No, I had like my braces were like braces. Now they're like on the inside and they're like Invisalign and nobody looks like a super nerd anymore.
I had the old school. I had headgear.
Yeah.
And
I didn't have a headgear.
Oh, shit.
But man, I remember I went in, I had a space growing in my teeth when I had my braces. And my mom was like, hey, he's getting a space there. And the orthodontist was like, I'll fix it. And then before I left the office, my teeth had closed. I was like, oh, really tight. Like, I couldn't bite into anything for like a week.
Jesus,
yeah, that's
man.
How they do it. They torture kids. It's fucking painful.
Do you know
where the dude's at?
You know?
Where the dude's at?
Where the dude's at.
Yeah, where are they?
Oh, where are or dudes or like the dude from Big Lebowski?
Mm-mm.
No, where are the dudes?
Yeah, in the general sense.
In the general sense?
Yeah.
Where are they at?
Where the dudes at?
Where are they at?
I don't know.
But what cities would you say?
Like, where would you mostly say there's dudes?
Oh, wait, where would
if you were on like a dude hunt?
If I was on a dude hunt,
like looking for dudes, where would you go?
Oh, I mean, you're here. You're a dude.
Hey, that's not a bad answer.
It's not a bad
I don't
answer.
Have to go too far.
Yeah, that's
your
actually
mom's house. That's
your
where the dudes
house
are.
Yeah.
That's
oh,
a pretty good answer.
Okay. Yeah. I guess I could have said that.
Yeah.
But then I'd be like, wait, my mom's house or your mom's house?
So I got to play this real quick. I tried to edit it down. This is what I was doing earlier. My sister came in town this weekend. One of them. And
how many do you have?
I have two.
Why did my voice crack when I asked you that?
I don't know. And you also asked it like very, like a detective.
Oh my goodness, how many do you have?
Yeah, I'm going to know how many relatives everyone in the room has.
So we talk about one of my sisters, and I never specify their names.
Sure.
But just for everyone's reference now, the one who I talk about her voice, because when I said so, she talks like that, and she's like, oh my God, like,
how old is she?
She's 35.
Oh my God.
She's like, Sasla.
Tell me, you guys are fucking retarded.
Her name is Maria, and she's not the one. So I tweeted, I said, my sister's in town. What do you guys want to ask her? I'll interview her real quickly. And everybody was like, why does she talk like that? And of course, it turns out that it was not that sister. It was my younger sister, Jane. So Jane came in and we did a quick interview. I tried to cut some of it together. So I'm just going to play a little bit for our listeners, if you don't mind.
No. And, yeah, I mind.
And okay.
Yeah.
And we'll get to hopefully there's some fun stuff. Now, well, here, I'll just play it.
Hopefully, you edited the thing. It better be funny.
I hope it is, too. I was rushing through it. Okay. State your name.
Jane Segura.
All right. Thanks for coming on the show, Jane. Don't worry. We're going to edit this part out. So, have you ever listened to our show?
No.
You've never listened?
No.
Do you know what it's called?
It's called Your Mom's House.
How did you know that?
Because I know, because you're my brother.
And you know that it, okay.
And I support you. I just don't listen.
Thank you. Thank you for your emotional support. People, here's what I did. I tweeted out that you would do the show. They would do an interview that'll play on the show.
Thank you for telling me after you did that.
Yes.
Now that we're recording.
Somebody wrote, Lumpy Gravy 76 wants to know if you wipe from front to back.
Yes.
You do.
When I poop, not when I pee.
When you poop, how do you wipe?
Well, I wipe from my butthole back.
Back up.
Back away.
From your butthole.
Into the toilet.
Do you go straight into the toilet?
I mean, I don't like rub it on me. Yeah, I go.
No, I understand you don't rub it on, but do you take a look at it?
No.
You never look at it? What's in the paper?
I mean, have I ever? Yes.
Yeah, but usually, no.
It depends. If it doesn't feel like it's right, like what's happening, then I'll look at it.
So, okay. But if it does feel right...
I mean, I don't feel the need to look at it.
Okay. All right. All right.
But see. I look.
Wait, can I just point out, first of all... Oh.
What happened? She
you
fell
guys,
down the stairs?
This no. is Top Dog's daughter. Like, does everybody understand the gravity of this interview? I don't know if our listeners are putting this together. This is Top Dog's daughter, and she's talking about wiping. Sorry. Okay.
Yeah, and she has no reference for any of the wiping stuff.
No.
You know, like, we talk about shitting and wiping a lot on the show. She doesn't know that.
Because she's never listened.
Right. So this
is supportive of her.
But that's why you guys asked.
It's amazing.
She's clearly she's giving it up.
I love it.
Okay.
It's a family thing.
I look.
Yeah. Okay. You take a look.
Is that you?
Oh, God. That was loud. Yeah. That was me. What did you think? Does it sound messed up?
Yes. I think I'm nauseous again.
Well, we were talking about my getting my ass waxed.
Yes.
And you didn't want to... I wanted to show you the pictures of it.
Well, it really started with the fact that I asked you if it felt good.
Right. And I said...
Yes.
Yes, but I didn't mean the act of waxing.
I know, but I meant after. Like, how did your butt and your ass will feel? And you said it felt good.
Right.
So I didn't understand why you didn't continue to do it.
Right.
And then you just wanted to show me disgusting pictures.
I want to show you pictures of the hair.
But I don't want to see pictures so you continue to do it.
I'm not saying I don't want you to not like the pictures.
But I won't.
I want you to like the pictures.
But I don't want to see them, Tommy.
But please look.
No.
Please.
No.
Okay. Have you had any recent dental work?
Who's this from?
this from Yinzer Jack.
Like she's gonna know them?
Yes, I've had cavities.
Recently?
No.
When was the last time you had a cavity?
A few years ago. I had a root canal when I was 4.
When you were 4 years old?
Mm-hmm. I like
you
how did? she refers to...
A few years ago, when I was four.
When I was 4 is a few years ago for Jane. Mm-hmm. That's not normal, is it?
Probably not, but it was what started me to be like horrified at the dentist because he yelled at me and mom...
What did he yell at you?
Because I was crying.
When you were 4?
Yes, and so mom freaked out and she still looks back on it and...
Shut up.
And makes her upset.
You're really good about flossing and stuff.
Yes.
How, what, did you start flossing more when you got these cavities?
No, I always took really good care of my teeth. I started flossing more when I had braces.
Did it make you jealous that I didn't need braces?
Well, your teeth don't look as good as mine, so no.
What? Excuse me?
I mean, my teeth are just better looking because you didn't have braces because your teeth weren't really bad, but they're not perfect like mine.
My top row is like...
They're not nearly as white.
I don't know about that.
She's right about that. Your teeth are like buttery popcorn.
Shut up.
They're yellow buttery popcorn teeth.
First of all, this is no braces ever, John. Look.
Where are your bottom teeth, though? Show me your bottom teeth. Pull it. Oh, they're so yellow.
No, come on.
They're not bad. Mm. Like I have no problem with your mouth.
And the top teeth? Yeah. No
but
braces.
Who's got
look.
Better teeth though, that's... John? Because mine, I had braces. Like,
come on.
Look how perfect and straight mine are, and whiter.
But you had braces, and I can't. The lighting in here isn't exactly like I can't see what's white
no
or
dent,
off
like
white.
No
or...
retainer.
Open your mouth. Let's see those ugly cavities. Ugh.
Yeah, but look at my.
Yeah, but you're not in this contest.
Oh, sorry. I want to have a shitty mouth, too.
No,
you have a great mouth.
I have 2 fake front teeth.
What
can
happened?
You tell? I knocked one out.
But you have, like, dog-like canines, you know? Like, you have, like, animal canines.
Really?
Yeah, you look like you have.
You've got dog. Look at his fucking wolf teeth.
You look like...
Canines look like, are dogs.
Right, right. But I'm saying,
stupid,
like...
Stupid, I know.
She looks like, so like she has, like, shih tzu teeth, right?
Like, oh.
Like a small... Can I say something? Your sister Jane is a great interview. I think she's great. I think she's very honest. And
I like her voice.
Yeah, yeah. Me too.
Yeah. She sounds,
she's great.
I feel like she's being interviewed by a professional.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying my
best.
We
need to have her on more. What else did she say? I want to hear more.
I'll play you a little bit more.
Yeah, okay. I like listening to this.
Top row, you don't think is as straight as your teeth?
No.
Look at my teeth.
Anyway.
You have kind of a monkey-shaped mouth, though. You know what I mean? Like, it kind of looks like a chimpanzee a little bit. Do you know what I'm saying?
Like...
Do you know?
Are you referring to a certain...
Like, there's a... Like, you know when chimps go like... Like that?
I am...
You have that a little bit in you, I think. Do you not think?
You look like you came from a different mother, so...
I think you look a little bit like a chimpanzee, but I mean that like...
In a sweet way?
Yeah.
Cool.
Do you not agree?
No.
You do this thing you told me where if you brush your teeth... really intensely on a Monday, you won't brush your teeth again for like 5-6 days.
Yes.
Why? What's the thinking behind that?
What?
That you made that up because I brush my teeth like 10 to 12 times a day.
Oh.
You don't brush your teeth for days and you forget.
That's not true.
It is true.
I've never not brushed my teeth for days. That's ridiculous.
At least 48 hours.
Can you do an impression of Maria speaking?
No, you and Christina are way better at that.
So I've been doing it on the show.
Yeah.
And they thought you, when I said my sister, they're like, ask her why she talks like that. And I said, it's not a different sister. But then they found a cartoon character. I don't even know who it is. It's a cartoon character called Lumpy Space Princess from Adventure Time. Have you seen this?
Definitely not.
This is the voice of the character.
Definitely
okay?
Not. Okay.
I'm going to say something fun like... Oh, yeah, I'm having a fun time.
Shit, you're dying! Oh, my God.
So, it's pretty much like Maria.
But I'm a dude.
It's pretty good, right?
It's really good.
There's another one here. Let's see if this also is more extended. Totally Maria.
Yes, and that's totally...
First, you should check out my house. It's like kind of lame, but way less lame than like your house.
That wasn't fun. That was lame.
I feel so crap.
What?
Nah. I totally saw Hot Dog Princess.
Because Maria's like, oh my God, So why does she talk like that?
I wish we could call her right now.
By the way, a few people sent that, the Lumpy Space Princess.
Oh, okay.
It is like almost a dead-on... like impression of my me doing an impression of my sister.
That's so weird.
You know, like I when they sent it, I was like, oh my god, like that's seriously.
Is it Adventure Time? Is that Bylock's thing?
I'm not sure. It's, I think it's a what's it called? Adult Swim thing, right? Is that what that is? Or a Cartoon Network show?
Not sure.
It really, really.
It's
made
really me funny because it does sound exactly like you doing Maria.
It kind of sounds like it, right?
Maybe they style sucked it.
And Jane has never heard any of the audio we played of my parents.
No.
Yes. None of it.
Okay.
Okay. Here, I'll,
I'm
we'll go
dying
on
to hear that.
I know, and get her on.
Yeah.
And I have. I thought I had something cool that I could play of her acting or sounding just totally.
But I would love for her to hear what you just played for me and then just hear her reaction.
She's like, oh my God, I'm telling you, I'm proud of that.
So it would be so awesome.
She always says the same thing. Oh my God.
I don't talk like that.
Every
you can tell by
time.
Jane's laugh that I'm not making
deal
it up.
Kim Deal?
She didn't know who Kim Deal was.
She is a musician. She's in the Pixies, and she's also in the Breeders. And she's like Christina's
she
favorite artist.
The mail.
Okay.
And then we see her sometimes walking down the street, kind of.
And perfect teeth and perfect vision.
You have.
Where did that come from?
That's so random.
Random bragging.
That's totally.
Also,
something.
My cartilage in my knees is good.
Jane is. That's totally something she
I
would say.
I have perfect teeth. I have perfect eyesight.
Have. A monkey mouth, let's be honest. And you have your teeth.
Are
you look
perfect.
Like you have an extra set of teeth in your mouth. Look like you have two rows of teeth, like on your top and bottom.
You're a shark.
Teeth.
You look like an animal, like a gorilla or a bear.
I don't look like a bear.
With yellow teeth.
I don't have yellow teeth.
Yes, you do.
Come
See,
on.
See, I told you.
And your beard needs so to be weird. Colored.
Colored? Which color?
So he doesn't know those gray spots.
No, the gray is good, dude. I get the. I'm getting the white.
My friend Roger's coming over. He used to do porn. I just totally just threw this in here. Hold on, you gotta hear this.
Roger, part. Who used to do porn?
Roger Lodge.
It made me so much fun to do
Blind
this
date
to
host?
To upset
yeah, he used
her.
To do porn.
Yeah.
Here we go. Hold on.
Used to be colored.
Colored. Which color?
So he doesn't know those gray spots.
My friend Roger's coming over. He used to do porn.
He's. Coming over tonight?
Mm-hmm.
What for? What?
Just talk, hang out. He's older now.
Okay.
He's like in his 60s.
That's gross.
But he'll tell you the best porn stories from back in the 70s and 80s.
Because you really want to talk about porn with me and some old man named Roger? Because that sounds about like the worst thing we could do. I mean, honestly.
What do you want? You don't.
I went to LA and we just do one night. We just met this guy Roger. He used to be in porn.
Yeah,
and it was really cool. He told really detailed stories. And my brother and I listened to them.
I think that's pretty cool, man.
I think that's disgusting.
That's kind of offensive to me.
I told our listeners how you gave
okay,
me.
Okay, so this is right here. Yeah. This is this. There's really popular clips from our show. Is when we talk to my dad and my mom. So this is one of the original clips that my sister has never heard, and she's listening for the first time. Okay.
Me great her, advice on how to wipe. Remember when I called you and I was like, I just keep wiping, and you told me maybe you're wiping too hard and you're going in.
Right.
You remember that?
Yes, I do remember that.
And what did you tell me?
You need to wipe down.
Wipe down. Mm-hmm. And also not. Push in.
Right, not to push in because it just drives you more in.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah?
What is your career?
Is that mom?
I'm proud to be disgusting. I hope this gives you joy. It's so disgusting.
I just do.
This is your wife, love for sure.
Oh my god. Okay. So. Now, what happened now? You wipe too hard. Like
you get dingleberries.
Well, not just that, but you can be pushing into your butthole.
That's right.
And that's why it's always brown
right.
Every time.
Right, exactly.
A little softer.
Right. That's right. Right.
Do you have any wiping advice for our...
My mother's so upset.
I'm helping my son with his comedy career.
This is my comedy career. How, what, do you have any other wiping advice there's a lot of guys that listen to our show.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of young guys, and you know, you have a lot more experience than we do.
Well, lately I've been using these medicated pads, you know, like, you know, the wipes people use to clean like their countertops,
yeah,
things like that.
Yeah,
they also good for that because they have antibacterial.
Really?
So I take
isn't
the,
that is that doesn't it like have like ammonia or something?
Yeah,
in it?
Sure. But, you poison know, in your butt.
Industrial strength.
Are you serious? You wipe with countertop wipes? Are you serious? That can't be healthy. That can't be. What the fuck? What?
Why is this in the bathroom? I use it to wipe myself. I have to clean the counter.
Ammonia. That can't be good for you.
What do you think of that?
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
I don't think I would have believed it if I didn't hear it. That was
you didn't believe it when I told you.
I know. That was insane.
Oh boy.
Mom was super pissed.
Yeah. She does not like him talking about dirty stuff.
Oh, I wonder why.
What? Can you put the microphone near your mouth instead of by your eye? You're like, I wonder why. You're holding it right here. Hold it here by
I'm
your mouth.
I'm not used to holding one.
Yeah. All right. Oh, fuck. What was Top Dog's explanation like of the birds and the bees? Did he ever talk to you about that?
No, but one time I got in trouble. And he had to drive me home. Or he had to drive the boy I got in trouble with home with his girlfriend.
Is that where you slept with the whole basketball team?
Yes, and the football team.
At the same time?
No, I mean just like in a row.
It's really gross, Jane.
Where the dude's at?
People want to know where the dude's at.
I don't know.
You don't know?
No.
Listen.
I have no dudes.
Where the dude's at?
Where are the dudes at?
I have no dudes.
Where the dude's at?
Where are they?
Right here.
If somebody were to ask you where the dude's at.
Where the dude's at.
Where would you say they are?
Right here.
In the room?
Where the dudes.
Where the dudes?
Yeah.
Is that the answer?
Yeah.
Do you know who's asking?
Where the dude's at.
Do you know who that is?
Yeah.
No?
I don't really know.
That's Casey.
Where the dude's at.
It's Casey.
From college?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
That's him asking.
I'd say right here still.
You still okay? So the answer, according to Jane, it's one of the questions that we ask a lot: is where the dude's at. Is your mother in the fucking stands?
What?
Is your mother in the fucking stands?
I don't even know what that means.
Who would you rather get filled up and sealed shut by, Joe Rogan or Red Band?
Or who?
Red Band.
Who's Red Band?
Butthole. Olive Garden?
I have no idea what you just said.
Okay.
I mean, Red Man, Olive Garden, what? I have no idea what you just
Death
said.
Death Squad?
No idea what you mean.
All right, let's see. Will you say, oh my God, you guys are so disgusting in an accurate impression?
No, because I'm not looking at something disgusting right now. But I kind of be like, oh my God, you guys are so disgusting.
That is very you.
Yes.
You did it. That's very in the moment. Oh my God, you guys are so disgusting.
Oh my God, you guys are so disgusting.
And then Maria's more like, oh God, like that. But she wouldn't say you're so disgusting.
But I would.
Right, but she would not.
You guys are disgusting a lot of the time.
Why are we disgusting? What's disgusting about us?
Like, the fact that you guys think it's funny to do disgusting things that involve poop and assholes and...
That's rude. We don't do things that involve poop or assholes.
This is really gross, Tommy.
Did you just turn your mic off?
For a second.
Alright. I feel like that didn't go the way it was supposed to go. Didn't finish, right? There you go.
Why are you so fascinated with poop? I think it's something the viewers should ask you.
They're not viewers. They're listeners.
Whatever.
I mean, do you think I'm fascinated with it?
Yes.
How come?
Because you talk about it.
Put the microphone by your eye. Okay.
Maybe it should be a headset. You didn't answer the question.
I'm not fascinated with it.
You focus on it constantly.
You think so?
Which that to me is a fascination.
You know, here's the thing. I feel like it's something that's, it should be discussed in the way you talk about family, friendship,
poop.
Yeah, or like taking a shit. Okay, let me explain. Taking a shit is one of the real joys, pure joys in life. Everybody loves taking a good shit. It feels good. It happens multiple times if you're lucky, or it should happen a day. It's part of your. It's part of life. So I feel like
it is part of life, but so is a lot of other things you don't talk
but
about.
But it's one of the good parts of life that you talk. People talk about sex. Sex is a great part of life.
And right? You could think shitting is
right up there. Number two, behind sex, maybe. No, three. Maybe behind sex and eating. Eating.
You talk about shitting a lot more than sex or eating.
Well, yeah, you're probably right, because I feel like I feel like he doesn't get his attention. You know, it's like the kid that you have a few kids and there's one who's not getting enough attention. Everybody's talking about eating and sex. Hey, what about shitting? He's over there. Yeah. He went to school today. He did his assignments.
That's very nice of you.
You know?
Yeah, totally.
Does it make sense now?
No.
What was it like having an actual bear for a big brother, asked Matt Kessinger?
I mean, it was fine. I really don't have a lot to say about that.
Okay, cool. That was a fun answer.
I mean, it was perfect. I mean, it's wonderful.
It was wonderful?
Yeah. Okay. I mean, he was a great brother. He always watched out for us. You could buy alcohol at 15 without being carded.
Thank you. It's a very neat compliment to give. Hey, tell us about your brother. Think about alcohol when he was 15. Is that what you're going to say at my eulogy? He could buy alcohol when he was 15. We got a card, everybody. Thank you. God rest his soul.
You have to admit, though, it was great.
I do. Put the mic by your fucking ear now. Hold it over your ear. Will you say, oh my God, seriously?
Oh my God, seriously.
But will you say it like a little, turned up a little?
Oh my God, seriously.
Oh my God, seriously.
That's not what I say. I say, oh my God, seriously.
Seriously.
No, you go seriously. I go, oh my God, seriously?
Oh my God, seriously?
Seriously.
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 And Maria, Sazla. All right, that's it.
She's great, man.
But I answered you tweeted me. Some people tweeted me questions 2 days later, which is awesome.
Yeah, it doesn't work.
But the guys who tweeted in the moment, I tried to get your question in there to her. That was the interview.
That was great. I got to say, bravo. Jane is riveting to listen to.
She's a good interview.
I like her voice. I like her honesty. I think she was a great interview.
Yeah, she was fun.
Daughter of Top Dog, you guys.
Yeah, absolutely.
And unbelievable.
Thanks for sitting here and
yeah,
listening.
Thanks.
Yeah, no, that's like,
sorry.
Come on like, over. You want to hear this thing I did?
I had to get it in there.
No, it's great. I was kidding. So, it was very funny. I don't know your sister.
Yeah.
So this was exciting for me.
Now, before you get out of here, because I know we got to wrap this up, but
it's that time.
It's time. Fill her up and seal her shut. We give you a couple options of who you want to fill up and seal shut, and you jump in. So. First we have, what's up?
Fill up with...
With your load.
With my semen.
Yeah. And seal her
and
shut.
And seal is like a, yeah. Like a cocking, like a...
With your semen.
With my semen.
Yep. Okay. It's all semen.
All semen, all the time.
All the time.
24 yep. Hours.
Semen.
Semen podcast.
Now, because this is a bearded episode...
Yeah.
Huck and Tommy Buns have beards, we're going to do a bearded episode, so...
Okay.
Wait, first we should probably... I have to fuck a chick with a beard?
No, you got to fuck me, and I tell them how much you filled me up.
Wait, what?
On the show, right now. Ready?
Hey. my pants. Put those back on. See, the people are listening.
They're listening.
The viewers don't know what's happening.
The viewers have no idea. So, here we go. Okay, bearded.
First, we should
read
the results, right?
Okay,
from last week. So,
we'll
last week...
explain how this works.
You guys jumped in and you voted. We threw out political. Wasn't last week the political?
Oh, we did. Yeah, we did like Sarah Palin.
Yes, yes. So, well, the presidential edition, we gave you Mitt Romney, Barack Obama. And we gave, you know, even though this probably our listeners are more Obama fans, this is supposed to be an aesthetic only, sexually
sex
excited.
Sex appeal. Yeah. Sex appeal.
So we said Mitt Romney's a good looking guy. You know, you can't take that away from the guy.
He is.
You know, a lot of people don't like him, but he's not a bad looking dude. You guys didn't care. 20 for Mitt Romney, 71 for Barack Obama.
Barry! Wow.
We throw in Ann Romney and Michelle Obama. 47 for Ann Romney. 147 exactly for Michelle Obama.
Wow.
Yeah, 100 more votes.
Yeah.
And then we gave you, just throw it out there, Hillary Clinton or Sarah Palin.
Oh, come on.
17 said Hillary Clinton.
No shit.
And 194 said Sarah Palin.
Wow, yeah. She's the beauty queen.
At least you guys are honest.
She's the beauty
queen. I like
queen.
That. That's why I like
talk
you guys.
To the 17. They're like, yeah, I want to fuck that lady with the man hair.
She's older, you know. She's busy. So that, she's got shit to do. She don't care, you know.
So that makes her...
Palin's just a beauty queen.
Oh, yeah. But, we're like, again, this isn't about politics,
no,
right?
No, you're not. Right. You're got, you know what? You're
it's
right.
It's about putting in the hole.
When you're right, you're right.
Filling it up and sealing it shut. Right.
There it is.
There you go.
So, give him his
all
options.
Right, here we go. Fill her up, seal her shut. Special Jon Huck edition. Guys with beards. I'm going to go...
I don't want to fill up any guys with beards.
You're going to.
Oh, I have to. Okay.
You're going to.
This is only pretend. You don't actually have to do this.
Okay, I'll stop masturbating now then.
Yeah. Okay, famous guys in history with beards. Abe Lincoln. You might know him from the presidency.
From freeing the slaves.
You might see him on...
From freeing the slaves.
And being
and
shot
pennies.
In the theater.
Is he on the penny?
Yeah, he's on the penny.
He is.
And the $5 bill.
And the fiver. So Abe Lincoln, who we all know has got a beard.
Illinois guy. Yeah. Springfield.
Or Billy Mays, the late, great Billy Mays, a very famous bearded man as well. Not as old as Abe Lincoln, but dead as Abe Lincoln.
Yeah. Just based on the photos I've seen... Abe Lincoln was like really tall and just gnarly, and like back then there wasn't a lot of like showering or
no
washing of the clothes.
I think he had wooden teeth too. Didn't he have wooden dentures?
Oh, good God! Yeah,
was that George Washington.
I think that was George Washington.
Oh, sorry.
But I mean, Billy Mays is a pretty energetic guy. I mean, you found out later that it was cocaine, but it was still
a lot of energy, positive energy. Yeah. As Brody Stevens would
positive
say.
Positive energy.
That was pretty positive. Good, man. You even had like Brody
enjoy
mouth
it.
Right there. Like,
do it again.
818.
It's good.
Shall Brody I die?
Yeah, I would say Billy Mays.
Billy Mays, huh? He's I'd take a load from Billy.
Wait, no. I'm filling him up. And sealing
it shut. All right.
It's however you interpret it.
Oh shit! I just.
Oh, right. Now we're into a dental audio. Update.
Shit! Switch. Hurry.
And you're like, because
your teeth.
You're like,
so wait. Final answer. Billy Mays.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gosh.
Okay, so you'd fill up. He's a big, aggressive dude. I think. I mean, when he was alive.
Well, I'm like I said, energetic. But I mean, I think
he'd be into it.
He was a positive guy. Like that's what a pitch man has to be. You got to be real positive.
Do you think
like,
he would get real excited about like how well you're doing? He'd be like, "There you go, John.
Yeah,
you know that fucking guy.
Yeah, dude, the guy can sell a mop to you know.
Sure.
Bam.
There's a nice head on your dick. It really fills me up. I feel
filled up and sewn shut or sealed shut.
Sewn shut.
Oh, you got nice hands, John. Boom, I can feel it. Ah, you got nice, you know, forearm strength is hereditary. Let's keep going.
Also, try this thing. It cleans everything. It's great. Clean the cum off my back. Oh, wait, there's none on his back because I filled him up and sealed him shut.
And I sealed you the fuck shut.
Tommy? Yes. Who are you going to go with, Abe Lincoln or Billy Mays?
Oh, I'm so excited about Mays. That's the thing about him. That's contagious.
Oh,
you know?
His positive energy. You like
really,
that.
I mean, there's something cool about being involved with the president, so I can see the appeal.
But if we're not talking about like stature as a human being, like of course Abe Lincoln did many more things that were way greater than anything Billy Mays ever sold to.
Arguable.
Right. Not for me, no.
Okay.
You know what, you guys? I'm going to have to dissent here. I'm going to go Abe Lincoln. Because I like tall and lanky sometimes. I think Billy Mays' stature. Well, no, I mean, like, that's
we put Tom on a rack. We stretch him out.
Okay.
And you know what? I know this isn't always true, but I feel like the tall, lanky guys have bigger peeners.
Jesus, babe.
Well, I know. I feel like Abe was hung, like, a lot.
Really?
I think he had a huge dong, yeah.
You feel like... You feel
she's
like
I can feel him in me. I can feel him in me right now.
I feel like taller guys have bigger wings. Yeah. Translation, I've been with some tall guys with big dicks. That's what that actually means.
I think Abe Lincoln had a huge hog. I think he had a bigger one than Billy. And I'm gonna
well,
go
Billy was
it.
All coked up. Give him a break. You got to let him come down off the blow.
But doesn't coke shrink your beanbag? And doesn't coke affect?
Yeah, it makes your dick tiny. You got to let it. You got to work it out. And I mean,
and
I've
bet
heard.
You. I bet you. Fucking what's his name? Billy would pound you.
I don't like
and,
that.
Well, yeah, you would.
A prison
he's
pounding.
He's gonna talk to you about how fucking much you're enjoying the pounding.
He's gonna talk. That's the problem. Is he's gonna talk my fucking ear off?
That's okay. He'll then sell you ear cleaner.
That's right.
You can clean up that ear mess.
He's going to sell you about what a good time you're having. I think it's going to actually
make it
all right.
Billy Mays could be fucking me and telling me that I'm enjoying it. I'd be like, yeah, you seem pretty excited
you know
about
happen?
This.
Billy's going to leave, and then you're going to be like, holy shit, what just happened? It's going to take you a while to realize what just happened because he got in your head. Head games went on and convinced you, like, this is the best time of your life. You've never come this hard before. Oh, my God. It feels good. I'm filling you up. And you're like, oh, yes, this is great. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Michonne, yeah. And also, he's playing the song Head Games by Foreigner as he does
that's
this.
That's how much Maze doesn't fuck around. He gets... Yeah, I'm
all
totally
right.
Sold.
So that's for the guys. And then for the girls, following the theme of bearded kind of lumberjacky.
Wait a minute. That was for the guys?
Well, I mean, of the guys in the bearded category. Now, okay. This is the girls.
Oh, for this is for the guys.
Right, correct. Yeah. Sorry, yeah.
Right. That was for the
girls. Semantics here. You know what I'm talking about.
All right,
about.
Where are the dudes at?
So, there you go. The chicks, we're going to go for sturdy gals. Number one, America Ferrera.
Okay.
You know who she is? Latin girl on some TV show.
Yeah.
Ugly
Betty.
Ugly Betty.
No, that's not America.
No, who
that's
is
some
that?
Other chick.
America Ferrera.
Google, will you Google her real quick?
Yeah,
I know
no,
she's all over the place. She might be on Ugly Betty. You might be right.
It's
sorry.
Not a show anymore, though.
No, it's gone.
But I forget what she's on. Okay, America Ferrera or Rachel Ray pre-weight loss. Rachel Ray the majority of her career until she was
Rachel Ray.
Really?
Don't even have to think about
it. This is
that
American
one.
Ferrara or Rachel Ray? That's what
yeah.
We're doing?
Mm-hmm.
First of all, she was the lead role on Ugly Betty.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. You're right. But I thought she was the brace face girl. Who's the brace face?
That's her.
That's
the
her.
The Ugly Betty. Really? Oh, yeah. Maybe you're right. Sorry, buddy.
Yeah.
You know, TV.
I didn't watch that fucking show.
Acting!
Yeah. Use your acting.
Yeah.
So, sorry. You said easy.
Oh, Rachel Ray. In a
and
second.
Why is that?
One, I used to watch her cooking show all the time.
Oh, she's great.
And two, who doesn't want to fill up and seal shut somebody that cooks like that?
That's
and she's
really
cute.
Point.
You know what I mean? I think she's. You say sturdy. I still like. Even when she was bigger, she was still tiny to me, though. You know,
Rachel.
I always felt like she was like a little midge.
Rachel's real normal, Midwestern looking.
Yes,
by
corn
LA
fed,
standards,
as they say.
Yeah, LA standards, she's a fat pig.
Oh no, by LA standards, she's horribly obese.
She's a pig,
she's an offensive lineman. We both know it. Who are we asking?
And she likes that kind of party. We're gonna be here all day.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
Yes, absolutely.
Tommy.
Without question, I'm Rachel Ray.
What about America? You don't like her?
Fuck no. I grew up around entitled Latina chicks. Oh, I've been the lead on an NBC show. Fuck you.
Wow.
Like, that's how she's going to be.
Wow. Yeah,
oh, you think you can fill me up and seal me and shut up? Show you who's boss.
Okay.
That's definitely... Right. I mean, you can't deny that Rachel Ray, I think, embodies the type of woman who lives... to take care of her man, at least in my mind.
Yeah.
So and
no, she does. She has to because it's
no
in my
way.
Mind too.
She's
and we're not the
woman.
Same person.
No,
so.
Dude, she's a career woman. She spends all day working.
And then
her husband
and then
is
probably
last.
Giving sweet blowjobs all night.
Yes.
Like it's probably like
no,
eat more chili while I just fucking go to town.
You're right. Oh. You're right about it. She is a career, but she's the type. She's a good-hearted person that
yes,
I feel like
I
she would be like, oh my God, I've been neglecting you with my shows and my cookbooks and all this
shit. She works
first
overtime
of all,
at home.
Here are the keys. You said you like Ferraris. I got you a Ferrari. And then also...
are you like blowjobs inside the Ferrari? I will do that.
I'll do that. And I got this new lube where I can finger you and blow you at the same time. And then I also made you...
He's like, wait, what's that? Don't finger me. What's that last part? Put the lube away.
I made
you're scaring me.
This ZD today that I told nobody they could try it, so I brought it just for you. So then you got your car. You blow.
She'd make
one.
You a frittata after she fingers her
and
asshole.
I feel like you can be a little demanding with her. You could be like, look, I want to fucking clamp your tits.
She would like that. She would like a little bit of the bossing around.
Yep.
Yeah.
And you could be.
And she's in charge of work all day.
I don't give a fuck about your show. She'd be like, I mean, I respect.
We're gonna watch Jardia or whatever her name is while you fuck her.
I would fill her up with my batter and be like, hey, why don't you make a cake out of this?
And then you would eat your own cum cake because it would be that fucking good because Rachel Ray made it.
She made it.
The Natural Harvest Cookbook.
I'm draining loads into Ray.
Okay.
Definitely.
Well, guys, I'm going to have to go against the grain here and
wait a minute.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
You really like the American Ferrara.
I'm a huge Rachel Ray fan. I have been for years. I love her personality. But as far as an effing goes, you can't beat the Latinos.
Wow.
Latinas now in this case. That's why I'm married.
Can you beat tall guys with huge dicks?
Do Latinas have big huge dicks too?
She might. She might. You don't know her. I like her beauty. I like her spicy Latin flavors. I'm into bold Latin flavors, which is why I'm married.
Yeah.
A bold Latin flavor myself.
Oh shit.
I'm a Segura, you know.
Hey-o.
There you
go. Hey tall guys with big dicks. I think I found you an inn. So all right, you heard it there.
Yep.
You go to facebook.com/yourmomshousepodcast. That's our fan page. If you like it, you can then you can leave comments. You can vote in the polls. It's a lot of fun. Make sure you check that out. Jon Huck, thank you for being here.
Yeah, hey, thanks a lot. Had a lot of fun.
Where can people find you, John?
I am on Twitter at JON_HUCK.
Don't forget that underscore, guys.
It's very important.
That other John Huck's a fucking asshole.
Well, he's not an asshole, but he's like a photographer or something.
Oh, shit.
Fuck that guy.
And he's not funny. But I mean, he's not a bad person.
You know?
No, but he invited me to a party once, which was interesting.
On accident?
No, he was like, hey, I have this party every year. We're both named Jon Huck. You should come. And he's somebody that I think other people I know have boned and like.
Really?
I showed up on set for a commercial and the wardrobe stylist like two different times was like, different woman was like, oh, I thought you were my ex-boyfriend, Jon Huck. And I was like, what? That's you did funny. The guy named Jon Huck? But yeah, I'm on Twitter. I'm on Facebook too. Jon Huck 1 is my fan page.
Right.
The number one. And
well, you're really easy to find. The underscores and the one.
My MySpace was owltooth /back. It was ridiculous.
It's like Mike Cronin in Cincinnati is Bone Snake 3.
Oh, yeah.
You remember that?
That's funny.
Two more Bone Snakes ahead of him.
Yeah. Well, I think that he talks about it on stage.
Yeah,
but
he does joke about that.
His dad time had like a internet handle or something that was like Bone Snake 2. He's like, who the fuck's Bone Snake 1? Grandpa? I'm Bone Snake 3. It's really funny. But yeah, don't follow that Jon Huck the photographer. You follow Jon_Huck the comedian, everybody.
I'm curious to see if this gets me any more followers.
What's the album called?
Oh, Fantasticular Hilaritation.
Fantasticular Hilaritation. They can get it
on buy it on iTunes and you can buy it on Amazon.com by going to the
Your Mom's House podcast
website and clicking on the banner.
And this is the quick update on the album because people have been tweeting me and asking me. My album just arrived, the hard copies, but I don't want to put those on sale without having the digital. So the company contacted me today and they said it would be like 5 to 7 days. So hopefully by the time the next episode comes out, you will hear that you can get the new album, which I'm very excited about.
What's it called?
It's called White Girls with Cornrows.
Nice.
This is a great one.
Is your second or third?
This is the second one. Yeah. Very excited.
The same material from the first, though,
it's
right?
It's the exact same thing, just remastered.
Well, yeah, remastered, then you put a different photo on the...
Wait.
I did. And I have a beat underneath.
Oh, good.
Yeah. You know what my favorite is? When you sell your comedy CD after you've headlined your comedy show, and people go, so what's the CD?
Like, yeah.
Well, it's a lot of the same stuff you heard, and by that I mean it's all the same stuff you heard, so give me the fucking $10 and get out of here.
But wouldn't it be comedy? Stand-up comedy? Yeah. Not music? The assumption is this music?
Yeah.
They don't know what it is.
So what is this?
Yeah. I get asked because of that cover.
Oh.
Right? They will, first of all, a lot of times people go, John Travolta. And I'm like, nah, man. And they're like, John Travolta. And I'm like, it's a parody of Thriller. And they're like, What's that? That kind of shit.
What's Thriller?
Swear to God.
Who the fuck has asked you what Thriller is?
All kinds of people.
You need to start punching those people in the face.
All kinds of people have asked me. But the other one I get is they're like, so what's up with this? Like, is this you singing?
Yeah, why would you sing? That's what I'm saying.
You just saw an hour of stand-up comedy.
You should say that. You should say, yes, it is me singing.
Oh, I've said it. It's my singing. They're like, that's cool.
It's opera. They're all disappointed. They go, we got to listen to this guy.
I don't want to hear this guy sing, man. Anyways. Yeah, but thank you for coming, man.
Thank you,
John. Thanks a lot. I appreciate it.
And Jeans, you want to say your goodbyes?
Goodbye, guys. Thank you for coming out to see us live. Thank you for listening to our show. We love you, mommies.
We love you. Make sure you come see us live again. I don't have anything else to
quickly.
Say. Quickly. We don't have much time.
All right.
We don't have much time left.
Fill them. Seal them up.
Life. Okay.